What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. In this video, I want to show you how I personally have Blender set up, but what's important about me is that I only work in millimeters and I'm all about precision hard surface modeling. So let's get straight into it. When you first load up Blender, it's going to ask you this question. Now, if you had a problem here and you didn't know what to click, don't worry, I'll show you how to change this right now. But for me, I put this onto search, I save my settings, click out. Now, those settings are over here under edit, preferences, and if you go over to key map, right here, you can change that exact setting. So let's first set up millimeters. So this is the first thing you're gonna find out is that here in Blender, everything currently is set up to meters. So let's change this right now. Over here, we have the scene properties and going into units, make sure that that's set to metric. I want to change the unit scale to 0.001. Once you've done that, change the length to millimeters. And that there technically is it. That's now in millimeters. However, you'll see that your grid has disappeared. To bring your grid back, we're going to go over here to overlay options and change that scale down to 0.001. And just so that you're aware, this changes all the units in all of Blender, which means that if you start scrolling out, this will start to cut out your scene really quickly. This is called the clipping point. So to increase your clipping point, go to the view and change this end. I usually just add another zero and you'll see that I can really zoom out now. Like I'm really far out, so I can see that. This will also happen that if you, when you start doing renders, I'm going to hit zero to get into camera view and lock the camera to my view. If I start zooming out, it's going to clip out as well. See? So make sure that when you're doing renders out on camera, camera settings, change this end as well. Because then you will actually be able to see your models that you render out. Lastly, I think now that that's it, that's you in millimeters, go ahead and play around. I'll have a lot more tutorials on how I set up a lot more stuff for millimeters. But if you want to see what I personally add on from this point for hard surface modeling, let's go and check out my preferred add-ons. So there's not many. The ones that I work with are the bool tool. This is great for cutting away. I use the loop tool. So loop tools. There's a lot of hidden features in this one there. I also use the 3D print toolbox. So usually it will just come up once you put in 3D. Let's see, come on, 3D. There it is, 3D print toolbox. And lastly, a very powerful tool that is very heavily underused is PDT, which is Precision Drawing Tools. I'll have a whole bunch of videos coming out on this one soon. And there they have all popped up. If they have not popped up there, don't worry. Sometimes you have to just click, go here, go into edit mode, go out of edit mode, make sure you select something and they will all be there. One last thing while you're here and you've done that, make sure you go here and save your preferences. And that there is how to set up Blender for hard surface modeling and into millimeters. And that's how to turn Blender into millimeter units for hard surface modeling, as well as all my add-ons that I use in my workflow. A big thank you to my patrons, and I'd really love it if any of you feel like supporting me if you enjoy my content. Thanks for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.